Today on Inner Workings, we have the pneumatic leg brace.
Most braces that are out there right now, basically they're not as intricate in the fact that most of the time they're just kind of like trying to limit the motion of the knee and make sure you don't like bend too far or anything.
It's more for stability, mm-hmm. and like especially for people who have like, I personally have dislocated my patella, so what I'll wear a knee brace once in a while to go work out, and it keeps the knee from moving side to side, or like just mm-hmm. more of a stabilizer than it is for, I'd say, like reducing the weight that's being put onto the knee.
So this is going to be the frame that's going to go on your upper thigh. We don't have an actual 3D print yet for the lower one because we're still deciding like what parameters we want to use for it. But yeah, so basically this is the outside frame, and then this stuff right here is going to be layered on the inside. So what we're going to do is we're going to take the metal and we're going to bend it and then cut it to whatever measurements are pertain to this exact thing. And then we're going to use this thing called an epoxy, which is basically just like a really, really strong form of glue. And then we're going to attach it to the inside of that. And then on top of that, we're going to attach this, which is just foam padding to make it so you don't have a bunch of metal that has some sharp edges scraping up against your legs and stuff like that. This isn't the final. This is just our first design, but this is a 3D print for the top frame. And like I said before, there's also going to be a bottom frame that comes with it. But I'm assuming this is just made in some metal fabrication shop. Pneumatics, I'm not necessarily sure where they're made at, but basically all pneumatic does is it just compresses air. And so that's like, if you look at like the shock absorbers on your car, it just kind of goes down and some of the air will get pushed down, but then it'll always go back up afterwards because it'll get released. If I had to assume, we're probably just gonna go down to the lab and just use whatever metal saw that we have to cut it, and then like I said afterwards, we're just gonna bend it and shape it to the exact thing. But the purpose of the metal basically is because this material isn't super strong and it's gonna have a lot of weight because it's your whole body weight from your leg, and especially when you're bending down, there's a lot of concentration on that. And so basically what this metal is gonna do is it's gonna absorb a lot of that force, and it's gonna make it a lot safer and a lot stronger, and it'll prevent it from breaking or having any form of injury. So we're mainly targeting people who are recovering from injury, or people who just might be older, might have pain in their joints, because what the brace is doing is it's essentially just taking some of the force that your knees and your joints and other parts of your leg would feel, and it's just kind of like dispersing it through this thing right here, which is not our pneumatic that we're going to be using in the final. What this does is it like compresses like this, and basically just what's going to happen is when you're going down, that all that weight is going to go down and this is going to absorb it and compress.
We found something when we were doing research that there's this group of people that made a exoskeleton that reduced the weight off, like it would actually enhance your ability to lift up things. So like there was this person who like went in one day without like the brace, and they did like maybe 20 squats, but then when after they put on this exoskeleton, the exoskeleton read what was going on and then used I want to say actuators or something like that. But it just read their movements and helped them lift up more. So they, instead of doing like 20, they did like 75 squats.